All right, for the Race Tech Privateer profile, we're here with Tristan Lane. So you're a long way from home, and I heard you here for a while in California. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I'm a Florida guy, so being in California is definitely different. We're staying in Anaheim. We're going to be here for 3 months, so just trying to get better at Supercross and immerse myself in the Supercross lifestyle. So it's been good so far.
Nice. So you come to California, sunny California, and it's like the worst winter we've had in quite a while. Like, it's just rain, go away. And tracks are messed up. Like, how has that been?
Yeah, I mean, it feels like home, man. It's Florida, right? It's raining all the time. The difference is back home, it rains and we're riding either that day or the next day. Here, we're flooded for a while. So, you know, I know you love mountain biking. I love mountain biking too. Between that and the dirt biking, I haven't had a whole lot to do other than surfing. So still making the most of it, getting my exercise in. But obviously, I wish I could be riding all the Supercross tracks.
Okay, so 3 months. Your wife's a nurse, I think?
She's
found some work out here too?
Yep, she has. She's a travel nurse, so we've kind of done a unique schedule where I come out here normally on my own for like a month before Supercross and outdoors and just, you know, couch surf and do whatever I can because it's so expensive here. Her job actually has a stipend for her, so we're able to live here pretty much for free. We have our house back home we're still paying for, but it worked out great and able to just, you know, kind of live the dream, so to speak.
Nice. Okay, the privateer life. You keep coming back. What is the carrot dangling that's keeping it going?
Yeah, that's a great question. It's just getting better. Like, I feel like I have so much more potential. And yeah. As I get better, you start getting in the mix a bit more and being on that bubble with main events, it's a lot more exciting than when you're just kind of like not really relevant in the race at all. So I guess the idea of trying to accomplish, you know, my dreams, it sounds cheesy, but seriously, like racing Supercross is a dream for me. So. I keep coming back. It's so fun, and I love to suffer in a weird way. This sport just fits all of my needs, so I just keep doing it, and I always say if I can just make enough money to keep afloat and pay my bills, I'm living the dream, so nice. Yeah, we're doing good.
So, 7-11 to, what is it this year?
Number 90.
90?
Yep.
Is this your first national number?
It is, yeah.
So what did that feel like to get your first national number?
It was cool. You know, I'm partial. I love my 7-11, honestly. Yeah. Like, everyone's like, oh, you don't want to be a three-digit guy. I love it. Like, I think that's just who I am. I love that number. So, but obviously, number 90 was cool, and doing it from the 450 class, I was proud of, you know, because I know when you're, a lot of 250 guys have some low numbers, but I was just pumped to earn it. Yeah, it's been good. Like, it gives you maybe a little more respect on the track. Maybe, you know, some sponsors like it at least. So, yeah. But for me, I like my 7-Eleven. So.
What was the 7-Eleven? Was there significance to that, or did you just get assigned it?
So I ran number 11 my whole life. And then when I went pro, I needed a three-digit number, obviously. And there was only a 7-Eleven available that had 11 in it. So I stuck with it. And everyone was, like, making fun of me. Like, oh, you're like the convenience store or whatever. I'm like, hey, whatever. I just missed out on the marketing with them. I should have hit them up while I was still 7-Eleven. But
nice. So tell me about the bike. What's the program like this year?
Yeah, it's it's definitely a privateer program. We're on a bone stock bike. I actually did get an XPR ignition in it, and that seemed to help a little bit. So we got some cone valve suspension from REP and bone stock
so
pipe.
So you on a KTM
everything.
Or a Husky?
We're on a gas.
A gas gas.
Yeah, just to stay on the old model. Yeah, just had some parts from it still. So
is it parts availability thing, or are you more comfortable with the old chassis? I'd heard bad things about the new chassis.
So I rode the new bike and I actually liked it. It seemed a little bit faster on the bottom end, and it's different. I think it's a little bit more stink bug compared to my model, which is a little bit more choppered out, if that makes sense. So I'm obviously comfortable with the one I have, but it really came down to parts. We just have suspension, wheel. I mean, we have so many things that I don't know that would transfer over very well. And just instead of reinventing the wheel, we just kind of stuck with what we had.
Yeah. So how does your program work? Do you have a race bike, practice bike, or is it all the same bike?
So for a while, just one bike, but recently I luckily did get another bike. So I have a practice bike and a race bike now. We're just trying to make them the same. That's where we're kind of struggling, is just trying to make them clones.
Yeah.
Because obviously you don't want to be, you know, powering out one bike and it's totally different than your race bike. So we're a little bit off on that end, but, you know, beggars can't be choosers. So we're out there racing, and whatever we got is what we got.
Nice. All right, well, your homie Moran's here has a website and everything set up. Is there anything available for fans to help you out?
Yeah, absolutely. Definitely hit me up on Instagram first and foremost. I check that regularly at Tristan Lane number 90. And then Facebook, I'm on there as well. My email is TristanLaneMX@gmail.com. But I know I'm not quite as fancy as Kevin. We're getting there though. Be on the lookout. We're gonna try.
Nice. Well, best of luck this year.
Thanks so much.